Assalamu alaikum, dear students. I am Shakeel. I am a lecturer of botany, government health second sultan. Today, my lecture is the remaining part of the biological classification of, or that is the two kilostomal classification. In case of kingdom plantae, here you know that the centrosome is almost absent while it is present in kingdom animalia. What is actually centrosome? What is it? It is a cell organelle present within the cell, which forms the esterus or the microtubules, which later on develop esterus, and these esterus help in the movement of chromosome towards the opposite spores, either it is mitosis or meiosis. That is, it is, but centrosome is almost absent in kingdom plantae, but is present in kingdom animalia. Now, second one is the inorganic crystallus. Inorganic crystallus are present in the kingdom plantae because they prepare, they store the inorganic crystals, while in case of kingdom animalia, it is absent. The inorganic crystals are almost absent in kingdom animalia. Sorry. In case of kingdom plantae, here, in case of kingdom plantae, the kingdom plantae does not show the care of their young ones or their offsprings. While it is present in kingdom animalia, that you know that in case when animals lay their eggs, they hatch them and they nourish their offsprings or their young ones, or they give birth to the young ones and they nourish them till they become dependent. So parental care is present in kingdom animalia. It is almost absent in kingdom vegetables, kingdom plantae or vegetable. Now, in case of reproduction, the kingdom plantae requires special external agents for carrying their pollen grains from one plant to another plant for cross-pollination or for self-pollination. That is, they require air, water, and insects. That is, insects carry pollen grains from plant to plant or flower to flower, or water carries sperms from one plant to another plant in case of rheophytas or pteridophytas. Similarly, air carries pollen grains from one plant to another plant. But in case of kingdom animalia, they don't need such extra agents because they are almost cross-breeding organisms. Whereas they do not need any kind of external agency or external agents. And the last one is, in case of kingdom plantae, they have the power of regeneration. They're each and every part can regenerate. If any branch is made to cut, it can regenerate. Or if a root is damaged, it can make a new root. It can develop new root. Whereas in case of animalia, the regeneration power is very less. If it is found, it is found only in the lower organism. That is, in case of the protists, they show the power of regeneration. However, kingdom animalia, they have in certain parts, they have power of regeneration, like our nails, they regenerate, like our river, it shows regeneration, like our hairs, it shows regeneration. But we take in hand all in respect to all the animals. If we take in hand all the animals, but that is, they have less power of regeneration. If they have the power of regeneration, that too is present on the lower organisms. So dear, this is almost everything I have dealt here with you. It is different criteria, different characters of the kingdom plant and kingdom animalia. Now, this kingdom has its own, what do you call as this, drawbacks. And I will discuss you these drawbacks, because this kingdom was later on discarded. On which basis this was discarded, I will give you in the second lecture. Thank you, Peter.